there, curious minds. Welcome to an exciting adventure where we'll explore the amazing world of computers and how they tackle tricky problems using something called brute force. Imagine you're on a treasure hunt. Brute force is like a super fast treasure hunting technique that computers use. Instead of looking for gold, they're searching for solutions to problems by trying every possible option. In this journey, we'll not only learn about brute force, but also discover its real-world applications. Computers have the awesome power of calculations, and we'll see how they use brute force, along with other techniques, to crack puzzles and find answers. Let's get ready to explore the fascinating world of brute force and how it helps in solving real-world problems. Brute force is a technique that involves systematically trying all possible combinations or solutions to a problem until the correct one is found. For example, if you want to find a four-digit password, you start with the simplest possible combination, like 0000, and then you methodically progress through every possible combination until you stumble upon the correct password. Since there are four digits, we can create the numbers from 0000 all the way to 9999, which is a total of 10,000 possible combinations. For a human, going through 10,000 possible combinations would be a slow process, so this would take a very long time. If it took a human 2 seconds to switch the lock combination and check if the lock opens, it could possibly take them 20,000 seconds, or a little over 5.5 hours, to go through every combination. That is not how I want to spend my time. Ask a computer to do this, on the other hand, and it won't mind at all. Computers are great at repetitive tasks and can try all 10,000 passwords in a fraction of a second. Imagine you have a 4-digit lock on your phone and you forgot the combination. Let's write a program to help us solve the combination. We will be using a function named testPassword that accepts our password attempt as a parameter. It will return successful if we got it correct, and unsuccessful if we got it incorrect. We begin with a for loop, looking through the range of numbers from 0000 to 9999. If our attempt matches the combination, we unlock our phone. Have you ever noticed that if you enter a password too many times, the software may lock you out for a little while? This is to prevent this type of brute force attack. Now, let's talk about how brute force is used in the real world. Cybercriminals often employ brute force attacks to gain unauthorized access to online accounts. Password cracking consists of the use of automated tools that systematically guess usernames and passwords until they find the right combination. It's akin to a digital burglar trying every key in the world until they find the one that unlocks the door. How do we protect our information from these types of attacks? Enter cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is the state of being protected against the unauthorized use of electronic data and the steps taken to ensure this. Let's take a look at three ways that cybersecurity specialists have devised to help increase security and prevent cyber attacks. One way to thwart password cracking is by implementing complex password requirements. This involves setting criteria for passwords that make them difficult for attackers to guess or crack. Complex passwords typically include a combination of uppercase and lowercase letters, numbers, and special characters. By enforcing these requirements, organizations can significantly increase the strength of their passwords and reduce the likelihood of successful brute force attacks. Take a look at this chart. If you create a password that is only lowercase letters, you can have up to 8 different characters in your password, and it will still be guessed correctly immediately if a hacker uses advanced password cracking tools. However, if you increase your password to 12 characters and use at least one uppercase letter, a number, and a symbol, that time increases to 34,000 years for someone to guess your password. But with computers becoming faster and faster, we would have to keep choosing longer and longer passwords. I struggle to remember a password with 12 or more characters. Luckily, there are other ways to thwart password cracking. Sometimes entering a password is not enough to log in. Certain websites send you an email or a text message when you log in, containing a special code that you have to type in along with your password. This is a process called multi-factor authentication, or MFA. Multi-factor authentication adds an extra layer of security to the login process by requiring users to provide multiple forms of verification before accessing their accounts. This typically involves something the user has, such as a mobile device or security token, or something they are, such as biometric data like fingerprint or facial recognition. By incorporating MFA into their authentication systems, organizations can mitigate the risk of unauthorized access, even if passwords are compromised. If you want to learn more about password security and multi-factor authentication, check out the lesson on account security in Miacademy's Computer Skills course. Have you ever wondered why sometimes when you log into an online service, you are asked to find all of the crosswalks or click on all of the motorcycles? What you are experiencing is cybersecurity at work through something called a CAPTCHA. CAPTCHA is a security measure designed to distinguish between humans and automated bots attempting to access online services using the brute force technique. CAPTCHA challenges users to complete tasks that are easy for humans but difficult for bots, such as identifying distorted text, selecting images that match a certain criterion, or solving simple puzzles. By requiring users to pass CAPTCHA tests during the login process, organizations can prevent automated password cracking attempts by bots and enhance the overall security of their authentication systems. But is brute force only used for cracking passwords? No way! Beyond passwords, brute force has applications in various fields. It's used in cryptography to crack encryption codes, in data recovery to salvage lost information from corrupted files, and in mathematical problem solving to find solutions when other methods fail. We've just come out of a tough battle with those pesky space pirates, and now it's time to get things back in order. But there's a bit of a snag. The control room door is locked with a 3-digit numerical code. I've got a feeling we can crack this code if we put our minds to it. Here's the plan. We're going to brute force our way through it until we find the right combination. It's going to take a bit of trial and error, but I know we can do it. Now, I've written a function called canUnlockCode that will help us out. All we need to do is pass in a code, and it will tell us whether it's the correct one or not. Simple, right? But here's the catch. The code has to be a number between 0 and 999. So we've got quite a few possibilities to go through. But hey, I've never been one to back down from a challenge. We'll start with 000 and work our way up, checking each code along the way until we find the one that unlocks the door. Once you crack the code, try the other tasks that are available in this lesson. Just think about it. Brute force is like a turbocharged treasure hunter technique that computers use to crack tough puzzles. Instead of hunting for gold, brute force allows computers to find the solution to a problem by trying every possible answer. Computers, with their incredible calculating power, employ brute force alongside other techniques to crack puzzles and find answers faster than we could ever imagine. But brute force isn't just about cracking passwords. It plays a crucial role in cybersecurity, helping us protect our online accounts from unauthorized access. We discovered strategies like complex password requirements, multi-factor authentication, and CAPTCHA challenges that add layers of security to keep our information safe. And guess what? Brute force isn't limited to passwords either. It's used in cryptography, data recovery, and mathematical problem solving, showing its versatility and importance across various fields. Be sure to complete the programming tasks, practice questions, and extension activities before moving on to the next lesson. And remember, in the universe of coding, the possibilities are infinite. See you next time. Hey.